The James Franco Comedy Central roast was last week, and it takes a lot for me to get offended. I am a comedian. I believe in free speech. I honestly can't remember the last time I was truly offended by words and not actions. But I was watching this thing, and it was just an endless onslaught of gay joke after gay joke after gay joke. But don't take my word for it. Let's watch.
To prepare for his role in 127 hours, he told me he spent 5 days with his arm inside the Rock. He goes by Dwayne Johnson now. I keep forgetting him. In this world, there can only be one James Franco. Because if there were two James Francos, they'd never stop butt-f***ing each other.
James recently won the Award for his support of the LGBT community. It's a prestigious award that's given annually. It's given annually. James is openly a very sexual person. I don't think James is necessarily gay or straight. I think he literally can't open his eyes enough to see who he's f***ing.
James, you're hard to roast. I mean, you're so dreamy. I mean, something about you, I just want to please you. I just want to take you back to my hotel room, take off all your clothes, and let a man f*** you.
Okay, that is just a small snippet of the endless night of gay jokes. You know, gay people are fighting for equality, and comedy generally is fighting the power. That's what you're supposed to do, I think, as a comedian. That's what most great comedians do. But here we have just a group of people that are sort of going to the lowest common denominator constantly. So again, I believe in free speech. They can say whatever they want, but should they be doing this within the social context of what's going on? James Franco released a statement about what he feels, how he is gay or not gay or something like that. He said, if that's what they were going to make fun of for me, I was like, great, bring on the gay jokes, because these aren't insults at all. I don't even care if people think I'm gay, so it was like, awesome. I mean, I wish I was. I wish I was gay. And this is the new thing where everyone always says, I wish I was gay. Tom Daley, the swimmer, the British swimmer that everybody loves, he said this week he'd be cool if people thought he was gay. Everyone's saying this all the time now. I think it's slightly pandering. But, you know, the roasts have also changed. You know, they used to be a group of friends, people that were big stars and friends like Ronald Reagan and Frank Sinatra and Lucille Ball that had inside jokes about each other. Now it's just a bunch of star fuckers, basically, trying to top each other so they can get a show on Comedy Central. Okay, so as a comic, Aaron, I'm going to start with you, and I believe you're a noted gay, so we're going to go there.
Super gay.
What do you make of this stuff? Because I'm going to venture to say you're cool with people saying whatever they want and joking about whatever they want, but sort of the low-hanging fruit here that they consistently go to while gay people are still trying to get equality seems weak to me.
Yeah, you know, this was just another example of what happens in comedy clubs across the country. It's just stupid straight dudes making stupid gay jokes. Yeah. You know, it's not creative. All those people up there, like, fine, you know, there's some great comedians on that day. So I'm not going to pull each comedian apart. But you can just tell it was just it was so stupid and ridiculous because they clearly they don't know James Franco.
Right.
And so they're just like, oh, he's gay, 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 gay. There was one clip of Aziz Ansari that I thought was the best clip of the night, where he was just like, oh, you're a good-looking man, and you're well-educated, and you read books, that means dicks are flying around your face. I mean, that really says it all.
Right, so that's a joke. He then turned the bullshit on them.
And it's just, you know, honestly, it is. It's absolutely ridiculous. I had a run-in with a comic in Scottsdale last Thursday, where he was so disgustingly homophobic on stage, and I had to rip him a new one off stage and then throw him under the bus on stage, and the entire crowd was with me. Like, it's the lowest common denominator. It's super. I honestly think I have more of a problem with James Franco saying, like, I wish I was gay, and then all those D-bags saying, oh, you're gay, stick it in your butt. Like, it's so stupid. I think I was just like, oh, please.
So now I said to Erin that I believe she's gay. JR, I believe you're black, if I'm not, according to my notes here. Would you be offended if it had been a black comic being roasted and a bunch of white people, because if he is or isn't gay, these guys all aren't gay. So if it had been a black comic being roasted and a bunch of white comics were endlessly just making black jokes.
It's happened.
Does happen all the time.
I mean, do you remember the Comedy Central roast of Flavor Flav? It happened. It's exactly what happened. When they went after Aziz Ansari, it was brownness jokes.
Yeah.
But there were so many black, charcoal, dark monkey jokes about Flavor Flav because, again, that's the easy bullshit you can come up with.
Yeah.
Because it's the same idea.
Yeah.
Over and over again. Now, I know we're almost done, but I spoke with Jimmy Dore about this. Mm-hmm. And I was like, you're a comic. I want to talk to comedians about this because I'm not. So these things have been old for me for a minute because they're not actually roasts. Do we forget what roasts were? First of all, these things are all written by the same guys. You see the credits, says writers.
Yeah, yeah,
now,
yeah.
You talk about the old school ones where they would actually talk about each other. And the reason it was funny is because comedians can come up with things off the top of their head. It's like, and people are like, well, I don't care. It was kind of funny. I was like, but the thing is, they're writing this off as a roast. Call it a written shit talk night
exactly.
Rather than a roast.
Yeah,
and then some people didn't understand me. I was like, think about it. If you're a hip-hop fan, when people write their lines, you're like, that's cool. But when somebody says, I'm a freestylist, I can freestyle, watch me flow,
yeah.
And then they can't do it, or they write it and read it, and they call themselves artists, you go, no, that's not a freestyle.
Right.
It's not what it was.
So we sort of think of the roasts as the old things that mm-hmm. they used to be, and you guys can go on YouTube and check out some amazing roasts,
some
classic comics and politicians truly roasting each other because they knew each other. So is the real problem here just sort of that I think as comics, we think, because the word comedy is in Comedy Central, that it's for all comics. It's comedy. It's
comedy
everything.
Comedy Central is straight men from 18 to 35.
Yeah.
That's the humor. That's their target audience. You know, they barely, they're not insanely supportive of really anything outside of that demographic.
Yeah.
And that's a demographic. It's like, you don't know them. You're gay. That's what I had to talk to that kid about on Thursday. I was like, he's like, oh, if I took out, he literally said the word faggot on stage. And I said, he goes, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend anyone. He said, if I took that word out and I put gay, would that be okay? I go, no, that wouldn't be okay. I go, as a straight man, you really, how about stick to stuff you know and not like, be creative about something else. Mm-hmm. And all those dudes up on the dais for that roast, it was just the same stupid joke about being gay.
Yeah, and I have to admit that for a second, I sort of didn't want to do this segment because I don't want to be the guy that's policing the comics or that's even policing the words or even policing the gay thing. Like it's endless gay stuff all the time. But I did feel that, so much goodness can come out of comedy because of the social change it affects and telling the truth and all that. But I felt like I had to.
Well, you know what it is? At the end of the day, it's been done and it's boring. You know what I mean? So get over it and write some things that are more creative and interesting, really.
And on that note, I hope this hasn't been done before and it wasn't boring for you. So get over yourself and subscribe. It's right down there. I want to thank Aaron Foley, J.R. Jackson. I'm Dave Rubin. Oh, we're switching studios, by the way. This is our last show in this Young Turk studio. We're moving on to bigger and better, so I hope you've enjoyed the ride while we did it. But we'll be in a new studio starting next week. Thank you for watching, and we'll do it again next week.